That includes, of course, the United States' commitment to supporting Taiwan's self-defense capabilities. The United States reiterates our long-standing commitments to enable Taiwan to maintain a sufficient self-defense capacity. And across all areas of our partnership, I want to reiterate and reaffirm something I said before the election, which is that our policy toward Taiwan will remain the same regardless of the election's outcome. The United States' clear and long-term expectation remains the peaceful resolution of cross-strait differences free from coercion. We oppose unilateral changes to the status quo. We do not support Taiwan independence, and we support cross-strait dialogue. While the government of Nauru's action is a sovereign decision, it is nonetheless a disappointing one. The PRC often makes promises in exchange for diplomatic relations that ultimately remain unfulfilled. It is disappointing to see distorted narratives about UN Resolution 2758 being used as a tool to pressure Taiwan, limit its voice on the international stage, and influence its diplomatic relationships.
All right, good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming to AIT today.
大家早, 谢谢大家今天早上来到AIT。
So today's media availability is with AIT Chair Laura Rosenberger.
今天的媒体见面会是和AIT的主席罗森伯格来进行。
And the chair will deliver an opening statement, and then we'll take some questions from you all.
首先，主席会先做一个开场致辞，接着再和接受大家的提问。
And with that, I'll turn it over to the chair, Laura, please.
那么现在我们就请主席开始致辞。Well,
great. Thanks so much, and good morning, everybody. It's good to see all of you.
谢谢您，大家早，非常高兴看到各位。
On behalf of the United States, I want to once again congratulate the Taiwan people on the successful completion of another free and fair election.
我谨代表美国再次恭贺台湾人民又一次顺利完成了一场自由公平的选举。
And of course, I want to congratulate President-elect Lai and Vice President-elect Shao on their victory and the other candidates on their hard-fought efforts. I also want to congratulate the successful LY candidates.
当然，我也要恭喜总统当选人赖清德和副总统当选人萧美琴在选战中胜出。同时，我也要为其他候选人在选战中的努力喝彩。另外，我也要恭喜每位胜选的立委候选人。The
United States looks forward to working with all the individuals the Taiwan voters have elected. And you've heard me say many times before that Taiwan's democracy is a model for the world, and Taiwan's elections are yet another example of that.
美国很期待与所有由台湾选民投票选出的当选人携手合作。大家都听过我说，台湾的民主是世界的典范，而台湾这一次的大选又再度证明了这一点。On
this trip, I was honored to accompany two distinguished former senior U.S. officials traveling in their private capacity. Former National Security Advisor Steve Hadley and former Deputy Secretary of State Jim Steinberg.
这次来台，我很荣幸能够陪同两位备受尊敬的前美国资深官员，以他们的私人身份一起造访台湾。他们分别是美国前国家安全顾问 Steve Hadley， 还有美国前副国务卿 Jim Steinberg。
The United States dispatched these envoys, as it has done following past Taiwan presidential elections, to convey not only the congratulations of the American people, but also to underscore the bipartisan support for the U.S.-Taiwan partnership and our support for a smooth transition.
美国遵循潜力，在台湾总统选举后派遣这两位代表来台，不只是要传达美国人民对于台湾的祝贺之意，也是要强调美国对台伙伴关系有着跨党派的支持，以及美国对政权顺利交接的支持。
Yesterday, the delegation met with President Tsai, President elect Lai, Mayor Ho, Chairman Ke, and Chairman Eric Chu.
昨天访团拜会了蔡英文总统、总统当选人赖清德、侯市长、柯主席以及朱主席。
You heard from Mr. Hadley and Mr. Steinberg at their meeting with President Tsai.
大家已经听到哈德利以及史坦伯格先生在与蔡总统会面的时候的谈话了。
In the meeting with the President-elect, the delegation again conveyed congratulations from the American people, discussed the importance of continuity in key policy areas, including on maintaining the cross-strait status quo, on defense issues, and on the economic relations and people-to-people ties, and discuss the importance of a transparent and democratic transition process with which each of us has had experience in the U.S. system.
而在与总统当选人会面时，访团则是再次传达了美国人民的祝贺之意，并且讨论了在关键政策领域维持延续性的重要性，其中包括维持台海现状、防卫议题，还有美台经济关系和人民与人民之间的关系，同时也讨论到透明民主的政权交接流程的重要性，这是我们每个人都在美国的体制中亲身体会过的。
And they underscored that U.S. commitment to Taiwan remains rock solid.
另外，访团也强调美国对台湾的承诺仍然坚若磐石。
With Mayor Ho, Chairman Ke, and Chairman Chu, the envoys underscored that the U.S. partnership with Taiwan transcends party lines, and that the United States will continue to work across the political spectrum in Taiwan.
在与侯市长、柯主席、朱主席的会面当中，两位代表也强调，美台伙伴关系是跨越政党界限的，而美国将会继续与台湾政治光谱上的所有伙伴合作。
We know campaigns are hard fought, but also know that all in Taiwan share a deep interest in what's best for Taiwan, regardless of their political affiliations.
我们知道选战过程非常激烈。但我们也知道，无论政党倾向为何，怎么做才是对台湾最好的，是关乎所有台湾民众切身的深刻利益的。
I look forward to continuing these conversations in my additional meetings the next few days with other senior Taiwan leaders.
在我本周接下来的会议当中，我也期待与台湾的资深官员就这些议题来继续进行讨论。
As in all of my discussions when I visit, I look forward to conversations on the strong cooperation between the United States and Taiwan on a range of matters, and how this cooperation will continue going forward.
就像我之前说过的，我期待我们能够就美台之间广泛议题的紧密合作继续进行讨论，同时也讨论未来要如何延续相关的合作。
That includes, of course, the United States' commitment to supporting Taiwan's self-defense capabilities. The United States reiterates our long-standing commitments to enable Taiwan to maintain a sufficient self-defense capacity.
这包括美国支持台湾自我防卫能力的承诺。美国再次重申，我们确保台湾能够维持充足的自我防卫能力的长期承诺。
As you know, we are seizing upon the full range of tools authorized by Congress and will continue to do so. And we commend Taiwan's recent defense reforms as steps that will greatly enhance Taiwan's ability to defend itself and underscore the importance of continuing them.
各位知道，我们正充分利用国会所授权的所有工具来达成这项目标，未来也会持续这么做。我们也相当肯定台湾近期所做的国防改革以及提升核阻力的做法，也期待未来在这个方面能够有延续性。
Our cooperation is also growing in the trade and economic space, and I look forward to discussing ongoing mutually beneficial initiatives such as the U.S.-Taiwan Initiative on 21st Century Trade and the Technology Trade and Investment Collaboration Framework, which facilitates two-way U.S.-Taiwan private sector investment in deals and high-tech sectors.
那我也非常期待接下来能够就这个美台的经贸领域来进行讨论，因为美台的经贸领域合作也不断的成长。那这一次访团也讨论了这个一些能够加强美台经贸合作的一些议题，像是美台21世纪贸易倡议以及美台的科技贸易暨投资合作架构，这项倡议也能够促进美台民间部门在高科技产业进行双向投资。
And across all areas of our partnership, I want to reiterate and reaffirm something I said before the election.Which is that our policy toward Taiwan will remain the same regardless of the election's outcome.
针对美台伙伴关系中的每一项合作领域，我想重申再重申一件我在选前就说过的事，那就是无论选举结果为何，美国对台湾的政策都会维持不变。
That's because U.S. interests in Taiwan and our deep and abiding interest in peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait will not change when a new Taiwan administration takes office. U.S. support for a robust partnership with Taiwan has remained consistent for decades and across different U.S. and Taiwan administrations.
这是因为美国在台湾的利益以及台海的和平稳定对美国的深刻且持久的利益，并不会因为台湾有新执政团队上台就有所改变。美国支持与台湾维持坚实的伙伴关系，这个立场在过去数十年来横跨美台历任政府始终如一。
The United States is committed to maintaining a strong unofficial relationship with Taiwan that upholds democratic values, deepens our economic ties, and supports Taiwan's meaningful participation in the international community.
美国致力与台湾维持强健的非官方关系，力求借此维护民主价值，深化经济连结，并支持台湾有意义的参与国际社会。
We remain committed to our One China policy, guided by the Taiwan Relations Act, the three joint communiques, and the six assurances. For more than 40 years, this framework has enabled the maintenance of peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait.
我们仍然致力遵循基于台湾关系法、三个联合公报及六项保证的一中政策，这一个架构使得台海在过去40多年来得以维持和平稳定。
The United States' clear and long-term expectation remains the peaceful resolution of cross-strait differences free from coercion. We oppose unilateral changes to the status quo. We do not support Taiwan independence, and we support cross-strait dialogue.
美国的长期明确的期待仍然是要在不受胁迫的情况下以和平方式解决两岸分歧。我们反对片面改变现状，我们不支持台湾独立，我们支持两岸对话。
Taiwan is a vibrant democracy, a thriving economic and technological powerhouse, and a force for good in the international community.
台湾是充满活力的民主社会，是蓬勃发展的经济与科技重镇，也是国际社会中的一股良善力量。
Our shared interest in maintaining peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait is not only central to the security and prosperity of Taiwan, but to that of the Indo-Pacific region and the entire world.
维持台海的和平稳定符合美国的共享利益，而且不仅攸关台湾的安全与繁荣，也对整个印太地区以及全世界都至关重要。
This is also why international focus on the importance of Taiwan and peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait has continued to grow substantially.
这也是为什么国际社会对于台湾的重要性以及台海和平稳定的关注与瞩目持续大幅上升的原因。
In addition to these shared interests, now is a moment to celebrate our shared values of democracy, of free and fair elections,and respect for freedom of expression that enables all to participate in the democratic process.
除了上述的共享利益之外，现在更是为美台的共享价值喝彩的时刻，包括民主、自由、公平的选举，以及对于使人人都能够参与民主程序的言论自由的尊重。
The process of Taiwan voters going to the polls to elect a new president and legislature is inspiring for me.And I know for many others around the world. And it's these shared values that also serve as a strong bond between us.
对我来说，台湾选民纷纷走进投票所，投票选出新任总统和立委的过程，非常振奋人心。而我知道，这也鼓舞了世界上其他地方的许多人。这些共享价值也正是将美台紧密连接在一起的坚实情谊。
I wanted to provide you all with a readout of the delegation's meetings immediately. Mr. Hadley and Mr. Steinberg departed this morning, and I want to thank them again for making this important trip.
我很想尽快提供访团的会后声明给大家参考。哈德利和斯坦伯格先生已经在今天早上离开台湾。我想再次感谢他们两位参与这次重要的访问。
I'm looking forward to my further discussions with Taiwan senior leaders and scholars over the coming days, and of course to enjoying more of Taiwan's amazing cuisine.
我也很期待在接下来的几天与台湾的高层领袖以及学者进行更多的讨论，当然也期待品尝更多美味的台湾美食。
My time's a little shorter than usual today, but I'd be happy to take a few questions.
今天我的时间比平常稍微短一点，不过我很乐意回答大家的几个问题。
So we'll go to UDN.
Good morning. Welcome back. My question is, Nauru has broken diplomatic ties with Taiwan yesterday, and what's your take on that? How concerning it is that Nauru is strategically along the Second Island chain, and will U.S. government be expected to send delegation to strengthen the Pacific Islands ties? Thank you.
Ma'am, I'll do the translation
first.
That's okay. Thank you.
Yes.
早安，欢迎您回到台湾。首先我想请教的是关于昨天诺鲁宣布和台湾断交的议题，不知道您有什么样的看法。那另外呢，诺鲁是在第二岛链上具有一个战略重要意义的一个国家，不知道美国是否会派遣代表团前往诺鲁来巩固与太平洋岛国的关系。
Thank you for the questionTaiwan is a reliable, like-minded, and democratic partner. We encourage all countries to expand engagement with Taiwan and to continue to support democracy, good governance, transparency, and adherence to the rule of law.
谢谢您的提问。台湾是一个值得信赖理念相近的民主伙伴，我们支持世界上所有国家与台湾进行往来，并且也支持民主，台湾的民主、良治、还有透明以及法治。
While the government of Nauru's action is a sovereign decision, it is nonetheless a disappointing one.
虽然诺鲁他们所做出的这个决定是他们国家自己所做的决定，但是当然对于我们来说是令人感到失望的。
The PRC often makes promises in exchange for diplomatic relations that ultimately remain unfulfilled.
中国常常做出在这个争取外交建交的时候会做出一些承诺，但是最后常常没有落实。
The United States will continue to deepen and expand our engagement with Taiwan on our many shared interests and values, support Taiwan's meaningful participation in the international community.And deepen our economic ties consistent with our long-standing One China policy.
美国会持续深化以及拓展与台湾的交往，来增强我们共同的利益以及共同的价值。它也会继续支持台湾有意义参与国际社会，并且会持续加深与台湾的经贸关系。上述的一切都符合美国的一中政策。
Okay. All right, we'll go with the Economist.
I'm really curious, China's Taiwan Affairs Office issued in its response to Taiwan's elections a statement that the DPP's victory does not represent the mainstream. Did you read that as a hint that China will continue trying to divide Taiwan, perhaps by working with opposition parties? And how does that inform the U.S.'s decision in you know, how much you're going to keep engaging with opposition parties?
首先我要问的问题是关于这个中国的国台办，他们在台湾的大选之后就发出了声明，提到说民进党的当选并不代表台湾的主流民意。那您认为这个是不是中国在暗示说他们将会持续的分化台湾，并且与台湾的反对党合作？那美国是否会这是否会因此而影响美国决定如何与台湾的反对党互动？
Well, thanks for the question. I did read their statement. I've made a habit of not speaking on Beijing's behalf, so I'm going to let them speak for themselves in terms of what they're thinking with the words they put out.
谢谢您的问题。我的确读了国台办的声明，不过我已经养成了一个习惯，就是不要代替北京来发言，所以我就留给北京来为他们自己的发言做诠释。
What I will say is the United States has deep confidence.In Taiwan's democracy and its democratic process.
我想表达的是说，美国对于台湾的民主以及台湾的民主体制深具信心。
U.S. interests transcend party lines here in Taiwan.
美国的利益在台湾是横跨党派界限的。
And just as we did extensively in the run-up to the election, engaging all of the political parties, the United States will continue to engage across the political spectrum, including in the LY, in the period ahead, because our interests, again, are across all party lines.
那美国会和我们在大选之前广泛的与台湾所有政党来进行互动的方式一样，继续的延续与台湾各个政党的互动，包括在立法院当中的这个不同政党的互动，因为我们在台湾的利益是跨越台湾的党派分界的。
Up Media。
我要很清楚地陈述我问题，所以我必须用中文。诺鲁昨天在建交声明里面引用了联合国2758号决议来作为他们转移外交承认的法律依据，那美国对这个动作有什么评论？这也是我们第一个原有邦交国引用这个决议去作为他们这个外交决定的理由。接下来我们会不会看到更多的例子的发生？
So Nauru, in their statement about their resuming of relationship, diplomatic relationship with PRC, they quoted the UN Resolution 2758 to explain why they have this shift of recognition. And this is actually the first former Taiwan diplomatic ally to quote this resolution to explain why they made this change.What is the take of the United States on this, and do you expect more of Taiwan's allies to shift recognition in the future?
Well, thank you for this question. I would refer you to the government of Nauru for an explanation of the unfortunate and disappointing decision.
谢谢您的问题。那关于诺鲁他们所做出的这个让我们感到失望而且并不满意的这个外交的转移的这个相关的决定，我觉得可能要请您向这个诺鲁方来请教，请他们做出说明。
UN Resolution 2758 did not make a determination on the status of Taiwan, does not preclude countries from having diplomatic relationships with Taiwan, and does not preclude Taiwan's meaningful participation in the UN system.
那联合国的2758号决议文并没有决定台湾的地位，它并没有排除任何的国家与台湾建立外交关系，也并没有排除台湾有意义的参与联合国的体系。
It is disappointing to see distorted narratives about UN Resolution 2758 being used as a tool to pressure Taiwan, limit its voice on the international stage, and influence its diplomatic relationships.
因此我们感到非常让人失望的是就是有人引用了联合国的2758号决议来作为他们与台湾断交的一个理由。那这个呢是并不符合这个我们的国际的这个期待。
The United States has been clear on our policy and our priorities regarding Taiwan.We are committed to our One China policy, which is guided by the Taiwan Relations Act, 3 joint communiques, and 6 assurances.
美国在我们与台湾的政策以及优先目标上立场表达得非常清晰，就是我们会依循以台湾关系法三个联合公报以及六项保证为准则的为基础的一中政策。
We enjoy a strong unofficial relationship with Taiwan, a vibrant democracy, and a leading economy in the region.We'll continue to expand our cooperation with Taiwan on our many shared interests and values, support Taiwan's meaningful participation in the international community, and deepen our economic ties consistent with our One China policy.
那我们会继续维持与台湾强健的非官方关系。台湾是一个民主社会，也是领先的一个经济的重镇。我们会继续的拓展与台湾在共享价值和利益上的合作，也会支持台湾参与国际事务，并且持续深化美台的经济关系。上述的一切也都符合美国的一中政策。
We'll go to CNN.
Hello, good morning. Thank you you so much for the briefing today. So the next Taiwan administration is going to cross into the year 2027, and a year when, you know, some people, including in the U.S. government, believe that Xi Jinping could potentially possess the ability to take over Taiwan. So I have a few questions about the delegation's meeting with the president-elect. Was there any urgency in asking the next Taiwan government to accelerate its defense capabilities, perhaps speeding up a switch towards asymmetric warfare capabilities? Or did President-elect Lai also raise any concerns about delays of shipment of weapons to Taiwan? Thank you.
谢谢您。那在台湾的下一任的执政团队，他们将会历经2027年的这个时期。那这个时间是许，这个时间点是许多人，包括美国的政府都表明说，中国可能会取得能够入侵台湾能力的一个时间点。因此我想请教，昨天的访团在与总统当选人会面的时候，是否有提到要增强台湾防卫能力的迫切性？或者是说台湾应该要转向以不对称作战战略的这个做法。那至于这个总统当选人赖清德总统当选人，他是否有向美方提到关于一些军备交货案受到延迟的议题？
Well, thanks so much. In the delegation's meetings yesterday, including with the president-elect, one of the things they discussed was the importance of continuity in key policy areas.And again, that includes on maintaining the cross-strait status quo, on a range of defense issues, and on economic relations and people-to-people ties.
谢谢您的问题。那昨天访团在与总统当选人见面的时候，他们特别强调的是在主要的关键的政策上的这个延续一致性、延续性的重要性，那其中也包括了维持两岸的现状，还有国防的议题，以及美台的经济关系和人民与人民之间的关系。
On defense specifically, and again, I look forward to having some additional conversations on these issues over the next few days. The United States continues to reiterate our long-standing commitment to enable Taiwan to maintain a sufficient self-defense capability.
那关于国防的议题，我很期待在接下来几天的更多会议上能够有更多的讨论。那当然，美国重申我们承诺要协助台湾维持能够足以进行自我防卫的足以进行自我防卫的这个防卫能力。
The United States is seizing upon the full range of tools authorized by Congress to support and enable this the fulfillment of this commitment.
那美国正充分地运用所有国会所授权的工具来充分地落实我们这项承诺。
And Taiwan's recent defense reforms are important steps, which we commend, that will greatly enhance Taiwan's ability to defend itself, and we believe it's important to continue these efforts.
那台湾近期所进行的国防改革是一个很重要的一步，能够强化台湾的防卫能力。那我们觉得非常重要的是这样的努力在未来能够持续延续。
Thank you.
SCTN 三林讯文。
主席好，我想请问哦，就是。因为刚刚我们提到就是那个习近平的第三任期，然后会遇到赖清德的那个刚好重叠的时刻，那我们想要请问就是美方要如何强化台湾的自我防卫能力，然后另外在因为南太平洋这个与中美洲中国势力正在渗透这些地区，那美国要如何协助台湾保住剩下的友邦，有什么具体的动作行为？谢谢。
Thank you very much. One of my colleagues just mentioned that the president-elect's term will overlap with the third term of Xi Jinping. And will the United States take any actions to further help Taiwan to boost up its self-defense capability? And my second question is that, as we have noticed, China has infiltrated into a lot of South Pacific island countries, and will the United States take any specific actions to do something there and to make sure that Taiwan can keep its allies.
Well, thank you. On the first question, I don't have any additional steps to preview at this point, other than just to reiterate that the administration will continue to seize all the tools that Congress has made available to the administration in order to continue to support Taiwan maintaining a sufficient self-defense capacity.
首先关于第一个问题，就是正如我刚才所说的，就是本届的政府将会运用国会所授权给本届政府的所有的工具，来支持台湾维持其充足的自我防卫能力。 那除此之外，在目前我没有其他的资讯可以提供。In
terms of the PRC's relations with South Pacific countries and what the United States is doing, I'll leave most of that to my my colleagues who handle some of those issues, but I can offer a few general comments.
那关于这个中国在南太平洋的行为以及美国会在那里有什么作为的问题，那我会请我负责这个领域的同事来回答。不过，我可以提供您一些比较概略的一些想法。
The United States has substantial interests in the Indo-Pacific and in maintaining a free and open Indo-Pacific.
那美国在这个太平洋地区有着巨大的这个利益，那我们认为印太地区的自由以及开放的这个印太地区是符合我们的利益的。You've
seen the administration take some substantial steps over the past few years, specifically with Pacific Island nations, to increase and expand engagement.
您可以看到，就是美国的政府其实在过去几年都采取了许多的步骤，来与太平洋岛国提升以及拓展我们双方之间的互动关系。And
I expect those efforts to continue.
那我预期这样的互动在未来也会持续下去。Thank
you. All right, New York Times.
Thank you. I'm sure that in your meetings yesterday, all of the political leaders reiterated their strong commitment to the relationship with the United States. But on the campaign trail, especially talking to KMT supporters, even TPP supporters, you would hear that you can't trust the United States, we've grown too close. So I'm wondering what your diagnosis of that sentiment within Taiwan is, what implications it has for US policy toward Taiwan. And if I could just ask you, you've made a number, stressed a number of times, dialogue with the legislative UN members. Do you have any concerns about whether the three political parties can come to a meeting of minds on the major issues of concern to the US, particularly the defense budget? Thank you.
谢谢您的提，谢谢您。 那首先在昨天，您与所有政党的互动当中，我相信他们都提到了，重申了他们对于支持美台关系的承诺。不过在竞选的期间，我们特别是看到国民党甚至民进党的甚至民众党的支持者，他们都会表达说不可以相信美国，我们和美国的关系太靠近了。那您对于这个一些台湾民众有这样的感觉，您有 什么样的看法？那另这个对于他们对于美国对台的政策的为什么会有这样子的一个感觉？那另外您也特别强调了，就是说要加强在立法院当中的与各政党的关系。那如果说这个立院当中的三个政党在一些议题上出现僵局，尤其是在国防议题上出现僵局，这个是否是会让美国感到关切的议题？
Well, thank you, Chris, for the question. I'll probably do less diagnosis for you and more speaking about what I think is in the U.S. interest on these questions.
谢谢您。那可能我的回答比较不会帮您进行相关的这个议题的分析，但是我可以跟您分享哪些做法是符合美国利益的。
First, I believe it's deeply in the U.S. interest to maintain robust and strong ties with all of Taiwan's political parties.
首先，我认为与台湾的所有政党维持坚实而且强健的这个关系是非常深刻、符合美国的利益的。We
know that Taiwan is a robust democracy that enjoys freedom of expression and that debate in a free and open society is a natural thing.
那我们知道台湾是一个蓬勃活跃的充满活力的民主社会，并且享有言论自由，而在民主社会当中，这种开放的互相的辩论是非常自然的。
And of course, that includes debates that happen during political campaigns, and that includes debates that happen in parliamentary sessions in the legislative UN.
那当然，这也包括说，不论是在竞选的过程当中互相的辩论，或者是在立法院的这个会期当中进行的辩论。
We also know that with the outcome of the legislative elections, it will be.Again, just underscore further the importance of having very strong relationships across all of the political parties in the legislature.
那我们从立法院的选举结果也看到了，让我们更加的认为，就是与在台湾所有政党都维持着密切的这个关系，对我与美国来说是十分重要的。
I'm not going to speculate on the ability of the various parties to come together in whatever configuration they may be discussing. What I do know is that it will be important, and AIT will continue to work again across the legislative UN to advance the interests of the U.S.-Taiwan partnership and the efforts that we are undertaking together that are of such importance to U.S. security, to Taiwan security, and to peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait.
那所以我不会过度猜测，就是在立院当中的政党他们的组成会如何影响他们的团结或者是讨论，但是我想强调的就是对于 AIT 来说，未来与这个立院之间所有的政党来继续的合作是非常重要的，既能够推动这个美台的伙伴关系，那也能够让我们一起努力来确保美国的安全、台湾的安全以及台海的和平及稳定。
And that concludes today's media availability. Sorry, we don't have any more time. The chair has a very packed schedule. I want to thank everyone for coming, and we really appreciate your time.
那么我们今天的这个媒体见面会就到这里。很抱歉，主席的行程相当的繁忙。那非常感谢大家今天的出席。
Okay.
Thank you all, and thank you, Sylvia, as always. Thank you so much.
谢谢大家。